a cheeky shot out there in Goblin Valley, I believe, is where he got it. So let's talk about today's image that is making us envious and making us think, oh, I wish I was there. It comes to us from Alistair Hamill. Let me get rid of the full screen and go, whoop, boo. Oh, man. So this, what do we talk about first? How do we feature this the best? So Alistair Hamill, it's J-O-O like Julia, Jew. So is it Juon or just June? Like I say June, how's the full name, man? So that is gorgeous, Mary Beth. It really is. There's so much to say about this Milky Way image. I want to tell a little bit of the story. Let's see if I can pull it up. Alistair Hamill. Oh, you know what? I can't pull it up. Not at least in time. Let me jump full screen and I'll use my iPad. If it's still on the background of this iPad, then we are good. So let's see. Do, 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 do. Yes, here it is. So let's look at all the information. Alistair Hamill. I live near the stunning north coast of Northern Ireland. I'm on full screen. That's okay, actually. Not too far off from the famous stones of the Giant's Causeway. You know, those basalt stones. They're so freaking amazing. It is a fabulous dark skies location. The cliffs behind soak up the light, and the views to the north are uninterrupted by the way all the way to the North Pole. So the way he's looking right now, it's uninterrupted all the way to the North Pole. He's seen pillars of Aurora process magic majestically across the sky there. He's photographed Deneb and picked up the nebulosity of the North American nebula, and Deneb is one of the stars. And you go do. The views there, uninterrupted to Spain, yada, when the lunar disappears. And he goes and says, and the interstellar light that had traveled out from the core of our galaxy and flooded the sensor of my Fujifilm X-T10 and on the back of my little camera screen, the most glorious detail appeared. And I might have dad danced, a wee Irish jig of delight. Alistair, awesome dad dance. And under cover of darkness, of course, so no one could see him do his dad dance, his Irish jig. And that was the moment I got hooked on the Milky Way core, a moment that would lead me to travel to the top of the volcano in Tenerife this summer in pursuit of more Milky Way goodness. But that's the subject of a whole other photography adventure. So, Alistair, awesome adventure that you're sharing with us here. It is an awesome picture to accompany an awesome story. So June Oscala, awesome. I gotta pronounce that right. So here is an amazing image. Let's talk about it. Why is it amazing? Well, you've got a lot of elements here of compositional balance that we need to talk about. So let me just draw some instant lines that show up in the image. You have your horizon line. You have your Milky Way. You have your shoreline. And all of this has a balance in itself. When you look at the negative space in between here, negative space up here, not to mark off Alistair's logo. And then the negative space that could be in here, but isn't negative space in this image, and negative space down here. You already can see between my lines and the marks of negative space how balanced it is. It's very evenly spread out. And remember, in this Monday moment of envy when we're live, you guys can jump in with any comments, any sort of praise that you want to give Alistair that I can put out here. The foreground leads in very nicely, doesn't it, Josh? Oh yeah, it definitely does. Let me pull out of this so you can see what we're talking about. So you look at this foreground and the focus that he has on these rocks that have really neat white lines on them. These white lines in this rock, I bet this is also basalt right here. And these stripes, they're bringing detail. They're bringing basically information that says, yes, this is definitely in focus down here. This is in focus. He was able to capture that and the Milky Way in great focus and great detail. So then this line of this foreground leads up and then it kind of jumps into this white line of here, follows all the way out to this point. Our eyes jump to the giant structure that is this sea stack right here, and then we have the Milky Way coming right off of it. The shape of the Milky Way. The strength and the weight of the image is all right here. And when you back out of all of this and you look at the image altogether, what do you see? First things first, light color, this structure, and your eyes go straight there immediately. And then you enjoy the entire image. And you go down and see, oh wow, cool foreground. Awesome way it works with this. So let's talk about a little bit about the lining up this in the dead center. Does it work in the dead center? Well, it sure does. because what we have here is a line that comes off this way and a line that comes off this way. So almost like the yin and yang of that shape, you have balance coming off of it. And the momentum is working. Doo, doo, doo. I was using the wrong hand. The momentum feels heavier here and goes lighter here. And then this part's lighter and goes heavier here. So that's balance, boom, boom. But then you also have what is happening in this reflection. What this space is looking like right here, because you went for a longer shutter, it makes all of these distracting shapes that could happen in here and takes them out. They're completely gone. And the only thing you see is a mirror image of this awesome structure that then, instead of becoming only this small in the image, it is now this big in the image. So it takes up the space very nicely. He also has the color of the Milky Way being smoothed out water. He could get the color to show up better right here. The color of the silhouette, the color of the rock over here, and then the color of the sky. The sky lights up. And so what is awesome about this section of the sky, and this isn't from Milky Way necessarily, this is light pollution that's happening over here. And it's possible it could be red air glow, but I think it's more light pollution than anything. There must be some clouds kind of picking up a little bit of that light, or just there's a structure over there that's lighting up this terrain, some city, something that's making this glow. But it's great, great that it has that glow, because then our silhouette is stronger on this rock because of the backlight. And so with this shape of color, this reflection of color, this silhouette, and then this going balanced, it's okay that it's dead center. This dead center doesn't make the rest of the image seem like, well, what's all this space for? Because he ended up with a nice shoreline, really in focus rocks that you can look at to make all the space down here interesting and worth it. Then above, your Milky Way will stretch off the screen, and so that takes up great in this space up here. That uses up all that we have up here very, very well. And then to complement the sea stack and this rock shape, he doesn't have a flat, boring line right here. He ends up with an awesome organic cliff wall that just carries up higher and higher and higher in his image. And it's so much stronger. We've talked about it a lot. It's so much stronger when you have a organic line that starts at one point and lowers itself down to another third. If it all stays parallel, all parallel lines, it's not nearly as strong. If you're going architectural photography, if you're going for symmetry in your shot, then straight parallel lines would be fantastic. But for landscapes, all the organic nature, cool landscapes, having that kind of a horizon line is so much stronger. Imagine if this image alone was just this horizon and this rock. It's actually got some simplicity that I like about it. Imagine if that was all ocean and it's still strong. You got the Milky Way coming off. It could be pretty interesting even with that, but then extra strength and extra points goes to having that horizon going up like that. It's just such a cool shot, Alistair. So let's see what some of the comments are. Nothing's coming in. Oh, here, Phil Sisto. I feel like I would have overlooked this composition because of the horizon in the middle. This is a time where breaking the rule works, though. Now, he's talking about the rule of thirds. You got your third, and you want to put your horizon almost always on one of these thirds. Sometimes we put it up here and then have less room for the Milky Way. So we typically put it down here and go like that. What would happen most likely in my shot, if I didn't think about what Alistair had here, is I would go for a rectangle shot. That's a preview of last week's image. Because this is a duplicate of that file, and then I just deleted that background, whenever I draw a line, it like shows the old image. It's a glitch in this program. So if say I had a horizontal line and I wanted to feature it, actually I should draw the horizontal square somewhere else. Let's do it so that this is in the third. See, I would be tempted, let's do a better square. I'd be tempted to do this, where on my third I have a horizon, and this thing breaks the third, comes up, and then this line goes up, and I got my Milky Way taking up some great space right here, and then this is just reserved for ocean water. Some coastline, but nothing featured. So Phil Sisto and I agree, oh, Mary Beth agrees too, that we would think first to do this. And why would I want to put that line dead center in my vertical orientation? Well, because of all the other elements in his shot that work great. Alistair knew. Alistair is a great photographer. If you see his website, alistairphotography.com, or I should say alistairhamillphotography.com. That site has a lot of information plus some ebooks if you guys want to check him out. He's a good photographer. He knows what he's doing, and he saw what he liked. He saw what he liked down here, the middle line, and then continuing it up. That has a balance that's way, way cooler than if we just gave up on this whole shoreline. Plus, one thing you've got to appreciate is this. Black with color of white. Speckles, 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 speckles. Well, what do you have above you? You got black or dark bluish purple with speckles, speckles. Lines from satellites that he kept in here. Speckles, speckles. He's got a theme of color, texture, all mirroring itself on the top and bottom between the stars, the satellites, and the Milky Way. And then the look of all of this interesting texture, interesting rocks, speckles, speckles on the foreground. So it's complementary in many, many ways. It's really cool. Hey, Paul Thompson. If you guys haven't followed Paul Thompson's YouTube channel, you want to see more Lake District or UK photography, Paul Thompson has some awesome stuff. So check out his YouTube channel. So Phil Sista says, but adding in that foreground is such a great element. Exactly. Completely agree with you, man. Let me go ahead and back this up. Ooh, go all the way to the beginning of all my speckled drawings and return to this. Man, Candelaria. Phil Candelaria is getting some extra attention today. I need to not do that duplicate like I did this time. So with Alistair's shot, we have really cool balance. We have really cool composition elements. We have textures balancing out textures. But I also want to talk about his color choices. You have this color in the rock that has a little bit of magenta, a little bit of red. This in here, this rock has the blacks, the whites, and then you've got this color of this bloom, and this color of the bloom kind of shows up in the water, and then this bluish gray water is very identical to the bluish gray that we have up here in the sky. And so we have a compositional balance with a color scheme. So when you look at the colors of these rocks and the way he's processed this image, these complement the pinks and salmon colors that are in here. And so that's a really cool choice, Alistair. That's a really cool choice of how you were processing this image to take the most of it. You're welcome, Paul. Absolutely. Rob Daughtry joined. Hey, Rob. So looking at compositional elements of balance and looking at themes and textures and color themes, I meant when I said themes, everything is strong. Looking at how he captured it, well, Milky Way typically is a long exposure anyway, so this terrain here probably by default became a nice soft long shutter shot, because if this wasn't long shutter and you could see wave textures coming in here, they'd be distracting and they also wouldn't show off the Milky Way colors that are up here and the silhouette as well. If you've ever taken a coastline shot and you have hard crashing waves and you have a structure like this, you won't see that structure with all the waves and the action and motion in that water. But when you smooth it out with a long exposure, suddenly it becomes this glassy reflection of this awesome structure. And so you don't want to lose that. And so consider a long shutter, even if you're in a situation where you're not taking Milky Way photography and you have something that is interesting like this and you want to see it reflected on your shot, go for a long shutter, an ND filter middle of the day, do something like that. It's awesome. So, you know, I don't know what else to say. I don't have Brendan here with me today to add any other comments, but we just really love this shot. It's a vertical orientation Milky Way, which is very rare. When you have a Milky Way that's this low, you almost always see it as a horizontal orientation. And so having him find a way to take advantage of a lot of the Milky Way, he's seeing a lot of this Milky Way, plus go vertical, that's fantastic. Well done, Alistair. Well done. If you guys want to follow Alistair, you can go to his website, but you can also check him out at Instagram with @ahamillphotos.com, and Hamill spelled with two L's. So thank you guys for joining me today on the Milky Way Monday Moment of Envy. Yeah, it's a definite Milky Way Monday Moment of Envy the last two times, but next week we're going to choose a landscape shot. So if you have any fall color shots out there and you're in our Facebook listeners group, go dump it over there in the Facebook listeners